Do you have a first or second generation Intel NUC from 2013 that you're wondering what to do with? Well, maybe it's time to upgrade it with a larger and potentially faster SSD. New SSDs are getting cheaper all the time, and these robust little computers are well worth keeping. For this upgrade, you need a 2013 model Intel NUC, Sandybridge or Ivybridge, a blank mSATA SSD card, a Phillips head screwdriver, and a USB stick with the installer for your operating system of choice on it. Make sure your NUC is disconnected from your electricity supply before starting. Turn the NUC over and place it topside down on your work area. There's a single screw in the middle of each rubber foot. Unscrew each one until you hear a click or feel a notch. Now gently prise the case open using your fingernails. You could use a flathead screwdriver instead if you prefer. Now the base lifts out, revealing the replaceable parts. This is the mSATA SSD that we're going to replace. Remove the single screw that holds it in place. The SSD will spring up when the screw comes loose. Make sure it doesn't fling the screw across the room. Your replacement SSD has two tabs, one short and one long. It only fits the slot one way up, so you can't screw this up. Screw it down instead. These are antenna wires that were connected to a Wi-Fi card I previously removed. Pull the clear plastic collars over the metal tips so they can't accidentally short-circuit anything. If you still have a Wi-Fi card installed, you can skip this step. Now put the base plate back on, tighten the four screws, and plug in your power supply, monitor, mouse, and keyboard. When you turn on your NUC, you'll get this message. That's because your new SSD is blank. To install an operating system on it, you need to have a USB installer ready. Watch my video, How to Make a USB Installer for Windows or Linux, to see how that's done. Just inserting the USB installer isn't good enough. You need to tell your computer to boot from the USB port first. This is done via BIOS. Turn off your NUC. Turn on your NUC. While it's starting, hit the F2 key to enter BIOS. In the top left of the BIOS screen, there's a section called Boot Order. Use your mouse to drag and drop the USB drive above the SSD. If your USB installer has multiple partitions like mine, put the OS bootloader partition first. Now click Exit in the top right corner of the screen. Click Yes to save your new settings. Now your computer will restart and boot from the USB port. This system is now installing Ubuntu, but up to this point the steps are identical regardless of which operating system you're installing via USB. If your USB installer isn't working, it might not have been properly prepared. Watch my video How to Make a USB Installer for Windows or Linux if you're stuck on this step. To find a new SSD to suit your budget and size requirements, check out the link in the video description. If you found this video helpful, leave a comment below and please subscribe to my channel.